Hey there! Welcome back to the third and the final part of this Prelims Mastery for the third week of December. I hope the past last two parts, 20 questions has really helped you. And here we are with the final 10 questions. Okay, so let's see if we can learn more through these 10 questions. Okay, so let's go to the first question of this third part. Which of the following statements are incorrect about Sahitya Academy? It was established based on the recommendation of Royal Asiatic Society of Bengal. Besides the 22 scheduled languages, the Sahitya Academy also recognizes English and Kashmiri. English and Kashmiri. Apart from 22 scheduled languages, it was established on the recommendation of Royal Asiatic Society of Bengal. So what do you think? Which of the following statements are correct? Incorrect here. Okay. Read the question properly. Check the demand of the question, read the options properly and then conclude. Okay, so let's check the answer now. It says B, only two. Okay, only the second statement is incorrect. However, the first statement is the right one. That means it was established based on the recommendation of Royal Asiatic Society of Bengal. That's the right one. Besides 22 scheduled languages, the Sahitya Academy recognizes English and Rajasthani and not Kashmiri. English and Rajasthani. So therefore, totally 24 languages, you know, has been kind of recognized by Sahitya Academy. So Sahitya Academy jo hai, wo 24 jo hai languages ko yahan pe swikarti hai. Aur 22 languages jo schedule 8 mein hai, unke alawa do aur languages jo hai, wo ek hai English aur dusra hai Rajasthani. So these are the 24 languages. Okay, let's go to the next option. I mean the next question. Which of the following statements are correct about River Godavari? The largest catchment area of the River Godavari is in Andhra Pradesh. Godavari originates in Triambak Hills, Maharashtra. So kya lagta hai? Dono mein se kaun sa hai? Sahi aur jo hai, you know, the proper statement here. Let's check. So it says only two. The second one is right. It originates in Triambak Hills, Maharashtra. That is a right statement. However, the largest catchment area of Godavari is not in Andhra Pradesh. It is Maharashtra. That is the right answer. Andhra Pradesh is the second largest catchment area for the river Godavari. Okay, now this is some of the, you know, some explanation here regarding the river Godavari. I want you guys to actually pause this, read the couple of paragraphs here, and then kind of add more value to your knowledge here. Okay, the next one. Which of the following are tributaries of river Godavari? Pranhita, Pravara, Manjira, Shabari, Indravati. So what do you think? Pause the video, think about this and then come back. Okay, so let's check the answer. Answer is D, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. All the 5 here are the tributaries of river Godavari. So please remember this. Okay, and the first one here, Pranhita, is one of the largest tributaries of river Godavari. Okay. Let's go to the next one. Which of the following statements are correct? Pinaka Mark II has a range of 40 kilometers. It is developed by Lockheed Martin Corporation, USA. So what do you think of these two statements? Which one is right? Let's pause the video. Think about that. And let's see if you can get the answer. Okay. Let me check the answer now. It is D, neither. So Pinaka is not developed by Lockheed Martin Corporation. It is actually developed by DRDO. It's an indigenous rocket system here. Okay, and Pinaka Mark II has a range of 70 to 80 kilometers and not 40. Mark I was actually 40. Now Mark II is the advanced version of the Pinaka rocket missile system here. Okay, now you can just pause the video. You can read this couple of paragraphs here. You'll get some idea about Pinaka. The next one. As recently seen in news, Operation Twist is option A, military exercise between Russia and South Africa, Indian police operation to control violent protests, open market operation of RBI, a new fiscal policy to twist the dip in GDP. So which of the four options do you think closely, you know, it relates to Operation Twist here? Let's see, let's check the answer. It says C, open market operation of RBI. Yes, that is the right option here. So what is Operation Twist? Operation Twist was, you know, conducted by RBI. It was open market operation wherein what it did is it bought the long-term bonds or long-term government securities from the banks. Okay, and it sold the short-term bonds to the banks. Okay, 10,000 crores worth of the short-term bonds were actually sold, and 6,000 or 5,000, close to 5,000 worth of the long-term bonds were kind of bought here. And RBI is still planning to go ahead to buy some more 3,000 to 4,000 crores of long-term bonds here. So this what will do is it will reduce the long-term yield. Okay, so this will increase liquidity in the economy here. So more the liquidity, more will be the spending from the people, and if people spend more, that means the GDP would be kind of pushed up. Okay, so that is the whole logic behind Operation Twist. Okay, the next one. Which of the following statements are correct? Corporate social responsibility concept in India is governed by the Companies Act 2013. Remember the act. The administration of the Companies Act 2013 is the concern of Ministry of Commerce. So what do you think? CSR, corporate social responsibility. Of these two statements, which of the statements are correct? Let's check the answer. It says one only. Yes, corporate social responsibility concept in India is governed by the Companies Act 2013. So Companies Act 2013 makes it obligatory for few companies whose profit is beyond some numbers here, big numbers. Let's not get into what number is that. That's not important here. It makes it obligatory for them to spend 2% of their overall profit for the social cause. Now that is called as, the corporate social responsibility. All right. Now this is as per the Companies Act of 2013. And which ministry takes care of it? Is it Ministry of Commerce? No, it is Ministry of Corporate Affairs, MCA. That is a ministry which actually takes care of this. So Companies Act 2013 was put forth by Ministry of Corporate Affairs, and it is their concern. So please understand, when you see companies, don't think, okay, companies may be related to commerce. No, things might not be as they seem. One of the proverbs here. All right, next one. Which of the following statements are correct about NASSCOM? So what is NASSCOM? It is a trade association of small and medium scale industries. NASSCOM initiated a program called 10,000 startups in 2013. 10,000 startups in 2013. So which of the two statements are correct? Let's check the answer. It says B2 only. So NASSCOM, yes, it initiated a program called 10,000 startups in 2013, but however, it is not a trade association of small and medium scale industries. Okay, now NASSCOM stands for National Association of Software and Services Company. Okay, now NASSCOM, it is a trade association of Indian Information Technology and Business Process Outsourcing, that is BPO, Business Process Outsourcing. So it's a group of industries which are more into services and not into manufacturing. Small and medium scale industries are more into manufacturing, all right, not less into servicing, but here they are more into services. Okay, so you can pause this very screen here, you can read the couple of paragraphs to know more about NASSCOM. Let's go to the next one. Match the following. At the left, you have naval bases at the left side of your screen, and the right side of your screen, you have countries where these naval bases are situated. A. Changi. B. Lamu. C. Marao. D. Bagamoyo. And E. Sitwe. And at the right, you have countries like Myanmar, Maldives, Kenya, Tanzania, and Singapore. So which of these naval bases are in which of these respective countries? You have to match them. There are options given below, A, B, C, D. I want you guys to pause this video and think about this and see if you can come up with the right answer. Okay. So now let's check the right answer. The answer is option A, that is Changi is 5, Singapore. So the port Changi is in Singapore, and the port Lamu is in Kenya. The port Marao, it is in Maldives. And the D option, that is Bagamoyo, it is in Tanzania, and Sitwe, it is in Myanmar. So these are the correct combination of naval bases and the countries. I'm very, I really understand that, you know, trying to remember these names are very difficult. But however, if you are, you know, if you keep going through these names now and then, if you keep revising them now and then these, you know, names become very kind of imprinted in your memory. All right. Now, these naval bases are very important because China, through its, you know, string of pearls, is trying to kind of cover the whole Indian nations by, you know, trying to come up with contracts or agreements with some of the countries mentioned here and trying to take contract of their naval bases, trying to establish itself into, you know, in their naval bases. Okay, and as an answer to them, India is also trying to come up with some of the strategies here, and we are also trying to sign some agreements with some of the nations in the Indian Ocean where even we can have our own naval fleet. All right, so this competition is going on right now in Indian Ocean. So these, you know, names here becomes very, very important in that regards. Okay, the next one. Which of the following statements are correct about Indian pharmacopoeia? What is Indian pharmacopoeia? Indian pharmacopoeia, the statement one says IP, that is Indian pharmacopoeia, specifies the standards of drugs manufactured and marketed in India in terms of their identity, purity and strength. It gets its power from Indian Drugs and Cosmetics Act of 1940. So this is a law which actually supports them as per the statement 2. So what do you think? Is the statement 2 right? Or is the statement 1 right? Both are right or both are wrong? Let's check. It says both 1 and 2 are right here. Now this was in news. Indian pharmacopoeia was in news because some of the drugs were declared subpar. That means not up to the quality. Okay, so hence some of the TB related drugs and some of the asthma related drugs were kind of declared as subpar, and they are now planning it to kind of take it from the market list here. And also some of the antacids were also declared as subpar. Okay, the next and the last question. Which of the following statements are correct about Organization of Islamic Cooperation? Okay, first one, Organization of Islamic Cooperation is an international organization of 57 countries founded in 1969. OIC has permanent delegations to the UN and the European Union. Its permanent secretariat is in Jeddah, that is in Saudi Arabia. So, of these three, which of the following statements are correct? Now, you should remember that some time back, Sushma Swaraj actually visited one of the summits of Organization of Islamic Cooperation, one of their meetings, if you do remember. Right, it was in news, and also recently this was in news because in Malaysia an Islamic summit was organized by Malaysian Prime Minister. Now some of the countries boycotted this very summit here because they said that this very summit should have been in those countries which actually represent Organization of Islamic Cooperation. Now which are those countries? Why was it cancelled? We'll not discuss now. Try to find the answer, then I'll explain you the facts. Okay, let's check the answer now. The answer is C, 1, 2 and 3. That means all the statements are correct here. So, because it was held in Malaysia, Saudi Arabia actually boycotted it. They said that it should have been held in Jeddah or maybe any of the, cities here in the Middle East and not in the Southeast or in the Southeast Asia. Okay, so that was what the reason, quoted by Saudi Arabia, and even Pakistan actually, they at the last moment, they kind of boycotted. They did not attend the Islamic summit, which happened recently last week. Okay. So this summit or this very organization, perhaps Organization of Islamic Cooperation, is basically to, protect the interests of Muslim nations and their religion especially. Okay, and even the latest summit which was held in Malaysia, they discussed about the threats and the issues regarding relating to the very interests of Muslims all over the world. And even the Indian the CAA was also discussed in the summit, okay, by the Malaysian Prime Minister. All right, so this kind of takes us to the end of the three-part series of December 3rd week's Prelims Mastery. I hope these 30 questions kind of added value to your preparation. Leave in the comment section as in how have you felt? Was it good? Was it bad? What exactly? How did you feel? I want to know. I want to know from you. I want to get the feedback from your end as in whether it is really helping you or not. Okay. If it's really helping you, then we'll certainly continue with Prelims Mastery. If it's not, then maybe I have to, shun this very Prelims Mastery, and maybe I have to come up with something else which you want. So tell me what exactly you want to help you with your preparation. My importance and my priority is you. As a coach and mentor of UPSC Civil Service Examination, it's my priority that your preparation, you know, should be made simpler and it should be made, you know, clutter-free here. Okay, that's the whole thing. So, tell me in the comment section what exactly are you looking for and how I can help you in your very preparation. Okay, so till the next week or, you know, till the next video, I wish you all the best. Like this, you know, very video here. Subscribe to the channel if you have not done so, and come back. Keep you know, kind of you know, guard to this very channel. Keep you know, coming back to our videos here. And next week we'll come back again with you know, we have Mains Monday series and also Prelims Mastery. So with your feedback, you know, we'll try to come up with a better video here. All right, take care. All the best. Bye bye.